Many feminists have critiqued the Smurfs. Yes, that's right, not even those cute little blue creatures are safe. Because there's one Smurfette in a village full of male Smurfs. And all the Smurfs are defined by either their roles, Handy Smurf, Chef Smurf, or by a character trait like Brainy Smurf or Jokey Smurf. But the one token female is just that, a token. She's defined by being female, and perhaps pretty. When popular media portrays multiple male characters and the one token female, it has come to be known as the Smurfette Principle. Feminists, like Cutter Pollitt, who coined the term, maintain that the Smurfette Principle illustrates society's disregard for women. According to Cutter, and I quote, "The message is clear. Boys are the norm, girls the variation. Boys are central, girls peripheral. Boys are individuals, girls types. Boys define the group, its story, and its code of values." And what's more, the et at the end of Smurfette, like the wo prefix in woman, shows that girls exist only in relation to boys. I'll reference this down the bottom, by the way. But is that the only way to analyse the Smurfs? Here's another one. Across cultures, we have seen that to be important to society, a woman merely has to be. A man has to do in order for his life to be valued by society. Now, gender theory looks at the reasons behind this, which is quite interesting in itself. And when I say gender theory, I mean real gender theorists, not feminists. But that's another story. So, society reduces men from human beings to human doings. And this can be seen in the Smurf village. Papa Smurf is defined by his role as father and leader. Handy Smurf by his role of fixing mushrooms. And even character traits define the male Smurf, such as Grouchy Smurf or Vanity Smurf, which we don't actually need because we've already got Smurfette. Ow! Like, Grouchy Smurf is only labelled with that character trait because of his constant complaining and moping. So he's still defined by what he does. And even though grouchiness is undesirable, his humanity, or Smurfity, is still incomplete without it. Smurfette, on the other hand, doesn't need to do anything. She is valued just for being. It's there in her name. The et at the end of Smurfette is enough for her to be valued by Smurf society, and by extension, human society, from which it arose, the imagination. In human society, the term man can refer to either all humans, man and woman, or can refer to man as opposed to woman, and it's usually understood by context. But woman only ever refers to a female human. Feminists, of course, see in this evidence of society's undervaluation of women. You're so down on yourselves, feminists. But let's examine this idea by comparison. The term animal can refer to all animals, including humans, or it can refer to animals as opposed to humans. But the term human only ever refers to human beings, us, never to other animals. So are we to believe that this is evidence of our undervaluation of humans by comparison to other animals? That we are only ever defined in relation to animals? This would seem to be the conclusion if we were to follow feminist reasoning. But obviously, the term human is used to not only set us apart from animals, but also to set us as superior to them. And this is the same for woman. Because across cultures and throughout history, women's lives have almost universally been way more valued than men's, and it's still extremely apparent today. And part of man's doing and striving is an attempt to attain the societal worth which has been automatically afforded to women. So, yeah, Smurfette is identified by her gender, but she is also valued for her gender. And that's a luxury that the little boys in blue just don't have. But I do realise too that, look, the Smurfs were created in Belgium in 1958, I believe. And public life was much more of a men's domain back then than it is today. So perhaps there should be a 21st century feminist remake of the original comic. I think that it could be quite entertaining. So rather than, you know, just Papa Smurf, he gets married. So we have Mama and Papa Smurf. But then, of course, she divorces him and, you know, he spends some time in prison on Smurfed up domestic violence charges, while she gets the mushroom. When he gets out, he moves into a shitty little toadstool down the arse end of the village, and he has to pay Smurfamoney for the whole village. Whew. But Smurf support for 100 Smurfs takes its toll, and poor Papa Smurf starts hitting the bottle pretty hard. Yes, meanwhile, Smurfette embraces feminism. She's a modern Smurf. She does put on a lot of weight, which her friends tell her is sexy. She also changes her name to Awesome Smurf and insists that everyone refer to her by the pronoun Smurf. Then, after an argument with Hefty Smurf, Smurf files false rape allegations against him, and he too goes to the doghouse, all the while maintaining his innocence. Smurf publishes a book on her journey as a feminist and a rape survivor, which becomes a bestseller. She goes on Oprah. But with fame comes scrutiny, and someone releases nude modeling photos back from when she was Smurfette. Also, an investigation reveals that Hefty Smurf was innocent all along. He gets released, but Awesome Smurf doesn't get into any trouble. Disillusioned with modern society, Hefty Smurf joins the movement of Sukdal, Smurfs going their own way. Eventually, with social disintegration, the Smurf village collapses, becoming fertile ground for the undead. It's the bum 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 Smurfpocalypse. Alright, so I got a bit carried away there. But there we go, there's my gender analysis of the Smurfs. Look, I will say you can read whatever you want to into anything. So the Smurfs become like a Rorschach blot. But we are so used to everything in society being critiqued through a feminist lens that we sometimes forget that there are other angles of analysis. Of course feminists see the Smurfs as evidence of patriarchal oppression, because that's what they see wherever they look. If they wanted to, socialists could see the Smurfs as an expression of class oppression and see in it the need for revolution. Or conspiracy theorists might see the Smurfs as evidence of an international Illuminati conspiracy. Anyway, that's all I've got to say for now. I have to get the Smurf out of here. See ya.